To the brave new world with action-packed comedies full of Navy SEALs and dirty blinds. Welcome to the revolution where ex-CIA madmen go AWOL in children's cartoons. No deposits, no return. A sickness prevails in the land. America, love it or leave it. Bloated egos with small minds, baptizing murder in the name of God and everything we hold sacred. Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, forever let us wave our banners high, high, high. Sitting here in the midst of falling leaves, overwhelmed by the symphony of freedom. Cocaine has become the law and order of big business and corruption, riding through the streets on the frowns of rookie cops who relieve their anxieties in the cold-blooded antics of shoot to kill. My country, tears of the sweet land of napalm, sweet land of napalm and unwritten poems of saxophones. Crying for those whose tears are stuck in reverse in the latest cable TV channel. And I hear the voice of nature whisper, the victory is yours if you want it. The victory is yours if you want it.
There was a park that where the last poets were born in, Mount Morris Park. And like every Sunday or every weekend, you know, people would go to that park and we'd be drumming and we'd be playing djembes and we'd be singing and dancing. You know, you have Black Panthers in one corner, Nation of Islam in one corner of the park, then the last poets be doing some here, and you know, Republican New Africa doing some here. And it would just be just Black people enjoying our Africanness, our beauty, and come to understand that we are beautiful people, that we are worthy of being here and worthy of having something to fortify ourselves, sustain ourselves in this country. Because I know one time the police tried to come in there and it was like, whoa. I mean, brothers came from everywhere and just beat them back out of that park. This is our park, this Sunday. You cannot come in here with prejudice and oppression and stupidity. And we beat them back out of that park. But those were the days, man. Those were the days.
So the buzz line at the time was, what is your thing, brother? Everybody was running around saying, what is your thing? What is your thing, brother? And when they said, what is your thing? Thing was like a weird kind of pronoun that meant, what is your political affiliation? Are you a Black Panther? Are you a Muslim? Are you a member of the Back to Africa movement? Where do you fit in? It wasn't like, I work for IBM or I work for DuPont. No, it wasn't that kind of thing. We're talking about, what is the thing that's going to help us liberate ourselves?
Bird lives. The death to all you hippo felines, lost in the darkness of oversized berets, sucking my blood with your well-publicized and juvenile poetry. I play for the gods, I play for Allah, I play for all those souls lost in your pretentious smiles and cool jazz as I continue my journey home. You stole my mother, you stole my father, and now you try to deny this one last tribute to God. You will not rejoice in my death. You will not rejoice in my death. You can't kill Bob. You can't kill Bob. The brotherhood is strong. Get him, Junior. Get him, Junior. Up jumps Miles. Up and breathing, sticking and moving, going against traffic on a one-way street, loving all the women in the crowd and in their dreams. Miles, the warm afterglow of an African sunset. Miles, miles, the warm afterglow of an African sunset. Someday my prince will come. Someday my prince will come. Miles, turning. Miles, miles. Miles turning his back.
Believe in yourself.
Miles turning his back on guaranteed death and low life insinuations perpetuated by the perverted fantasies of the founding fathers of these United States of a fuck you, motherfuckers. Fuck you, motherfuckers. The powers that be are always thinking about, you know, keeping power. So they find ways to keep power. And at that time, you know, we had the power of the system in America back on the hills for a minute. They were reeling because there were so many people coming after us. You had the Last Boys, you had the Black Panthers, you had the Nation of Islam, you had the Republic of Rafa, and then you had some of the white kids, the SDS, the Weathermen, and, you know, you had everybody was at the oppressor, and the oppressor was like, whoa, we gotta find a way to, like, you know, stem this tide. We can take all, everybody that comes at us like this, you know, it's too much. So they found, for us as black people, for the nationalists and for the Panthers and for the Nation of Islam, they found some Negroes who wanted to, didn't know who they were, or didn't care about who they were, didn't love who they were, in programs, and they start infiltrating groups like I was in, Islamic group that I was in, and they start filtering groups and, you know, fomenting disunity and self-destruction and turning brother against brother. And it was called COINTELPRO, and it really worked. It worked very well because some of the most powerful groups were evaporated or were dispensed because of the terror and the internecine violence that was going on between us.
Thou shalt not kill. That's not part of the American dream. Because the kill's a thrill. They love to show on your TV screen. Romance the gun just for fun. Drop a bomb just for charm. This is the American way. And all of this talk about equality, justice, and peace, spewing out the mouths of these governmental beasts. But every time blacks tried to find a way to do for self, the American terrorist wasn't having it. And fear is all black folks felt. For 400 years, blacks have lived in fear of the vicious cruelty of the race. Trying to march for justice and the civil right to be treated fair. Attacked by dogs and fire hoses. Living a life of total despair. Bombed a church in Birmingham while the children were in Sunday school. Took the lives of four little girls. Yes, this terrorist is just that cruel. American terrorism is like a virus that's homegrown and spreads across the planet too. Selling guns and chemical weapons. Gift wrapped in red, white, and blue. Blue.
Paranoia was a big thing back then because folks were infiltrating the Panthers and doing a whole lot of things that were just disrupting the movement. And the government has a lot more money to pay people to disrupt and cause trouble. So we were suffering from that type of behavior. And so Kane had this little paranoia, and he thought that Umar was a member of the CIA, or he was a plant, he was an FBI informant or something. And I didn't feel any of that.
So it was a very deep time, and you just saw people dying and being killed just because they were who they were. They were trying to bring forth the truth.
You know what? You can't kill what you can't see.
He will get high in a crack house and do his poetry.
Yeah, well, I got high in crack houses. I got standing ovations in crack houses doing poetry. I'm just doing my poetry. Because, you know, sometimes I'd be like, when I was really out there, I'd be in a house and I get to speaking, and somebody say, wait a minute, your voice, because people always remember. They said, wait a minute, ain't you? I said, yeah, we're talking about that later. Give me a hit now, motherfucker, because we're talking about the other shit later. I want to get high. We're talking about me being a last poet later.
Now, he had that weird situation. I had even a weirder situation because I'm in the joint when the album hit the street.
Yeah.
I was given 12 to 20 years. And I turned and I asked my lawyer, right? He says, oh, I wouldn't look forward to parole because you're from out of state and your crime is political. You know, they got you down as a militant, you know. But during that time, the last poets were going through another kind of situation.
So welcome to the times of the last poets. Da, 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 da. Oh, yeah, we was fighting in the street.
They were fighting.
We was fighting. Me and David was fighting, and Kyle and Kane and Jalal was fighting.
Physical fights.
The last poets are fighting in the streets. This is madness! This is madness! And Felipe called me and said, where the fuck you at, motherfucker? Bring it on. I'm saying, fuck you too, you punk motherfucker. Come on up here. You hit my boss. I said, man, I'll kick your fucking ass, Felipe. Bring your little motherfucking Puerto Rican ass. Yo, I got some for you, Muma. I got some for you. I mean, we was like some thugs, man. It was some gang shit going on there.
And Felipe came straight out of a gang.
Yeah.
Felipe.
He had just served time for killing somebody.
Felipe had a gang called the Young Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah, he did. If you're in the last poets, you gotta be crazy.
Un rifle, oración, conflicto tradicional, pero yo, si dudar es vivir, pero cadenas son cadenas, son cadenas. Retratos de Ponce brincan en mi mente, cuerpos tirados en la calle. La consecuencia de ser libre es la muerte. Tiros y gritos y tiros y gritos. Y Lorca se ríe porque él sabe. Y sabe por qué. Hermanos, tenemos que poner nuestra fuerza, no en un espíritu, pero en y la gente sigue tirando y orando y tirando.
We saw the United States beginning to disintegrate. We wanted to help in the disintegration.
Ceros, ceros, nada multiplicado por nada, con nada. Un rifle, oración, conflicto tradicional, pero lloro. Pero yo tiro y lloro. Y tiro y lloro. Y tiro y lloro. Y tiro y lloro. ¿Tú me entiendes, pana?